I have the pad open.
Right.
So I can start off. It says, do you have occasions to use Emacs for multilingual text composition? How do you deal with spell checking, etc.? I have written only in English. For English, Emacs works great. Spell checkers work great. I have not used it for any other languages. I have indeed tried local South Indian language, but only the script. I've just given it a shot. Only the script I could get, but not the spell checker. Really, I've not really found that out at all. So that was my trial to answer the first question. The second question is it possible to align the columns and headings and subheading? Oh boy, that's a good one. I actually felt the lack of having the theme I had was great for it to look like a novel when I'm typing out the novel itself. But when I expand into the sub trees, it sort of goes haywire. It's a bit tacky. You can probably switch to a monospace font, and that works better, than the font that I have demoed it. You can perhaps try monospace font, and it should work, I think. Okay, as far as I know. So that's again, that's the second question. The third question is, maybe there should be an Emacs for writing mailing list and online writers workshop. This is a great one. I have conducted an online writers workshop here in India. Of course, it wasn't an Emacs focused workshop, so we used Notion as the tool. It worked pretty good for people who are not aware of Emacs and how to use Emacs, the keystrokes. The fact that I wasn't using the mouse sort of unearthed them. It was a scary experience for most people. So I had to switch to Notion, which worked for so people use that as a template and then they could type it out. Wasn't my perfect experience. I like the Emacs org mode experience much better. The next question is, how do you share drafts of your novel? If you use Pandoc to export to Word, etc., how do you incorporate feedback on the document back into org? And thank you for the kind words. Yes, it is a problem with my this is my non-fic, and I have a dedication to Space Max also and the Emacs org mode community in there as well. I don't know if you can see it, probably not. I did use export it to Word. My editor did complain that there are a whole bunch of things that it wasn't convenient for her. So I tried having the raw org mode itself in a doc embedded, and I would do a copy and paste. Didn't work so well either. So I'm still on the edge on how do I do this. Should I train my editor to use org mode in GitLab or one of those other tools, which is not a great experience? I don't know. So it could be tricky for working with people who are not well versed with Emacs. Pandoc is very, very useful in converting it to PDF and integrating it with LaTeX, the styling, formatting into e-reader, EPUB format. All that Pandoc works great. You can customize it, and of course, there's a lot of support in the community for any style changes that you want to make, any images that you want to add. It works great. So let me see. I that was my trial to answer the Pandoc question. Can you show exported PDF of any of your novel? Unfortunately, it's still not published. So I will put it and share it on the community part of this itself somewhere in the schedule itself. Thank you for that question. Unfortunately, it's not yet published. So I'm unable to publish the exported PDF. But I will make a test of an op- an open source novel that I'm working on, I will definitely publish that so that you can see how it works also. Can you text trap in the columns? I have not found a way to do text trap in the columns. That only shows my limitation in config setup, but I'm sure people can figure this out. That's a good one. I would have loved to have it. So every time I want to write more on the headline, I would get out of the column view mode, and I would do the typing and expand it, and then come back into the column view when I want to set the other meta parameters. So that's how I managed text trap without the text trapping feature inbuilt in the column. But I think it's a great idea to have text trap. Did I leave out any questions? I don't think so.
I think there's at least one question on IRC, which I'll leave read
to you. Please, can you do that, please?
Sure.
Thank you.
Yeah. So they ask, how do you collaborate with others while writing your novel? For example, sharing your file and getting feedback.
Okay, good question. So far, I have used, what did I use? So this is a crazy hack, but it's a long-winded way. I would, right now, we're working on an ebook for sustainability, and kids contribute to their stories into this long org mode file. And I want my editors to see it. So what we have done actually is, with the tags and all that, I have actually pasted it into Google Docs. So that my collaborators and the editors can see it. That's my current solution. It's not elegant. I'm trying to see if I can use Python code to make at least the copy and paste work. But it's not so elegant for now. So I don't know how to work this out. But this is my hack. That is, the entire org mode text, I would paste it into Google Docs so that my collaborators and editors can see it. And whenever they edit it, I ask them not to make any changes to the org mode tags. So I would just copy the entire text and push it back into my org mode file, and export it using Pandoc into a PDF. And since it's synced to Google Drive, it shows up in their Google Drive, and then the collaborators can see the PDF / EPUB. So they want to open it up in their own space. So it's a very, very hacky and I think primitive Stone Age sort of solution. But I did see a Python solution to at least help me with the copy and paste. I'm still working on how do I convert this. This interconvertibility is driving me nuts. I think most of the questions around the interconvertibility. So this is what I have right now. Any other questions? IRC or
let's see. Stop? I think that's about it.
Okay, cool. That was fun. Thank you so much, the organizers of Emacs conference and the community at large, the org mode community and the Emacs community, for helping me out. Thank you so much. Thanks for the opportunity as well.
And thank you, Bala, for your awesome talk.
Thanks a lot, Amit. Cheers, guys.
Bye.